Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome to another episode of Hearts of Iron 4, Modern Day and Vatican City. So our current situation is a bit special. We could maybe invade United States right here. Grab some more land. Or actually, grab some more provinces that once were ours. Slowly expand and invade United States, Canada. Well, United Kingdom too, since it's only United States and... yeah. Only United States and United Kingdom will actually bring down to have a victory. But the main problem we have right now is factories and navy. So factories, well, we can't build a larger navy than they have currently. Eventually we would, but that would need so much time. I was thinking, can't we fix that somehow? We're taking down small nations right here, gaining some factories, and I'm thinking, what else could I do to speed that up? Take larger nations. So how about going in right here to Iran? You have 30 military factories, 30 civilian, and well, 14 naval factories. That's gonna be quite good actually. And we're also supporting by land, so our tanks should just be able to roll over, and then we will also reach these people, and we can probably go in and grab Turkmenistan, Uzbekistan, and maybe even China if we would like to go to war with them, or Russia. So, I think we should open up more options to us. So, that's what you're gonna do at least. You are not gonna have this plan anymore. I don't care. If we are having so much trouble bringing down the navy because our navy is so small, we don't even have complete control over the Mediterranean right now because of this single freaking province. And they have so many submarines right here and just keep reinforcing that, so we can't completely break them. We have too few destroyers. We're trying to build more of them, but it takes so long time, and I don't want to sit here and just wait. So, yeah, that's basically my plan. You, please, go right here and start, well, the invasion right here. Let's see, we're going to justify war goal. 120 day, yeah, I'm completely fine with that. And right here, you tanks too. We have 17 right here. I think it's time for you to leave. Actually, maybe I should leave some. Okay, we're gonna leave, let's see, let's leave 5 of you. Actually, that's perfect, yeah, definitely leave 5 of you. So the rest of you are gonna go right here. Let's just assign my fleet to start, well, guarding these divisions on your, well, movement down, since, well, I don't wanna lose that many. So yeah, we're gonna have 5 left here, just in case of some invasion that might succeed or whatever, just to have 5 tanks right here. The rest of you, well, go right here. We're gonna invade Iran, and yeah, it's gonna be nice. We're also invading right here, so basically I'm gonna keep cleaning up all nations we can right here in Africa. Just basically getting more factories. Enough waiting. I need action. I need to do something. I need to push forward. Since Vatican City, you have been very strong. You have been waiting for me for a very long time now. Oh crap, we're getting 13% nukes every single time. Whatever, every single day. You've been waiting for me to do something big for a very long time, and I've been like holding off, just being very careful now. Why? This is the time not to be careful. This is time to push, to grab land, to expand, to become one of the greatest power on earth. The Vatican City should be the Vatican Empire, should be the Vatican World Conquerors. Or, well, at least Vatican Conquerors, so we can bring down United States and United Kingdom. Their navy is a pain, and I need to fix that. I need to make sure that, well, we are the supreme beings in this. So let's double check now. Let's change this out, and you'll see if we can assign a couple. Really? Nuking me once again? I just wish I could nuke the sea. You know, you are fishing with dynamite, but I guess I could. Can't I be fishing with nukes and just find these god-awful submarines right here? So, hello, fleet. What's going on? Didn't I pretty much tell you to go right here? But you're right there and not moving. Please move right there. Alright, move one province. Very good. And now please move there. Cool. And let's, why not defend that too, since 16 ships apparently right there. So, you destroyers, you are killing several submarines each, but you're taking two heavy losses. But this time, you are going to be allowed to go back and retreat. I'm going to have repair priority on average. And let's see, I want automatic split off enabled. Very good, destroyers. Keep doing that. 14. Very nice. Just a ton of submarines that need to be brought down. And speed 5. Holy crap, I must have accidentally speed down. Outdated equipment, improved anti-air. Are we producing anti-air guns? Yes, we are. Oh, so yeah, let's fix those. Very good. Someone's really complaining about me not upgrading and looking that. So I'm sorry, but... Well, it's not super important right now to upgrade instantly to next level. We have enough. Or basically everything. We could use a tiny bit more troops. So instead of only having, let's see, 11, let's have 21. And we still have enough equipment. We have loads of main battle tank. We have loads of mechanized. So let's even increase this one to, 36. And now we're finally missing some equipment. 1,000 tanks, actually. Okay, that might have been a tiny bit too much. Let's do 29. 30. And let's deploy you right here. And let's just do it as one go. Very good. Anything else we're missing? Are we like, oh, our factories are finally getting repaired because, well, they're nuking us less and less. Only in the bad territory. Well, actually not that bad territory, but at least not the best territory I had, since we have cleaned up most of the things they can reach in Africa. So, what is there anything we're kind of missing? Attack aircraft, maybe some more fighters would be needed. Okay, so we're gonna do one Mark 1. We're going to do some Gen 3 attack, some naval bombers, and a tiny bit of Gen 5 bombers. So one line right here, then just increase four lines. Oh, we actually have enough almost for that entire thing. Very, very good. We need even more steel. So hello, European Union, let's trade some more with me. We are importing 48 chromium when we definitely don't need it. Where did we get all of this? What's something we took right here? Oh, it might actually been. Or I'm confused. I'm also like confused, but well, I'm happy we actually don't need chromium anymore. Rubber, we need anything else? Rubber and tungsten. So yeah, let's fix that. Some more rubber and some more tungsten. We will most likely actually fix that too once we take Iran. This is gonna give us a nice general boost of resources. We don't need most of it, but at least some of it. Let's see, U24, you are quite decent, or actually, no you're not, you're all basically recruits. How long before this war goes on? Okay, quite a long time, so let's just train everyone right here. Right here, this is more experienced one, I was going to say, but have we increased this one? No, you're still the same one right here, so this should be fine, so let's just trade both of you. You have how many days before war? Actually, only 10 days, so you can actually hold off on that. Yes. This shouldn't be any problem. Airplanes, right here, please. And yes, we can just assign you whenever you're done. Very good. Right here, how much do you have? You actually have a very big air force. Wow, I'm impressed. So let's get out some fighters. Let's see 1,000 of you. And once we once we have broken half the nation, it's gonna be fine. So let's assign just another 500, another 700, and let's see, I want a couple of nukes ready for dropping, basically. That should be enough. Cool, very good. Basically nukes just to finish off the war more quickly, since they have the capital right here in the first part of the nation as talked about. So if I nuke it one or two times in total. Actually, we can grab that territory too. Then they should pretty much surrender once I grab it, so we don't have to push the lost half of the country. And finally, we have some new tanks. And finally, we soon have this. I wonder how many episodes I forgot to fix the land doctrines. I'm really sorry. I'm gonna keep saying it. I'm really sorry. So 1,000 day, that's actually only about 300 years. 3 years. And that's gonna leave us 5 years out of time. Yes, I just did that. Let's just never speak of it again. Reliability or soft attack? Actually, I would like the soft attack. Wait, European Union, you're not happy enough with us? Oh, you're not. Let's improve relationship then. And we are then gonna, well, most likely cancel you and just brief. Actually, that you should just update instantly when they pick you. So, European Union, come on, be a bit more happy with me. It's gonna take a couple of days, so we can probably finish you off before that. Your improved relationship is visited. Okay, so a billion nations are improved relationship with you, not the other way around. Alright, that should be fine though. You have the best commander, so let's just go in. Go in and finish you. Finish them. Come on, just go in from several directions at the same time, and you are now falling back. Very good. Let's grab the capital, and that should most likely be it. You have 57%, yeah, your capital, and gone. Very nice. And you are not surrendering. It's really one more day. Boom, good. And support, or and support what? And your nation's existence, we should probably just assign you in two different lines right here. And very good. So that's gonna be it. We have enough, good enough supply right here. Yes, we do. What I'm putting both ruins right here is you're pretty big. Around the 60 divisions, they can be. We could have a problem with only 24 divisions. I'm just doing it for double safety reasons. So you're also gonna train as soon as you arrive, since these guys are getting pretty good. And we have enough equipment, right? We have enough main battle tanks, and we have enough mechanized. Very, very good. Right here, everything is looking fine. We're still getting nuked. We are, well, slaughtering their submarines. Yeah, one by one. Actually, they were carriers, even. Here, yeah, cool. Just more and more submarines getting sunk. At least damaged and then sunk. Let's see, how much do we have? 12, 13. We have 6 units right here, all of you in preparing. And how much do you have? 18 ships still. Alright, then we are just gonna continue doing that. Hopefully wear their fleet down slowly but steadily. We have resource slots, alright. Let's just continue right here. Recovery rate 0.2. Organization plus 10. So how good is the organization now on our tanks? It should have been quite nicely bumped. Yeah, actually, I think it was... How much could that have been? Maybe 4 extra? Just from that extra organization on all our mechanized. Very, very nice. So all of you, let's see. We're going to have this one. Did you apply right here? Yes, you must have applied right here, right away. Let's just double check. Yes, you're designed by... Well, German actually, but yeah, European Union. Cool, so 980 days, we're gonna have some really good tanks. And that's why I'm not gonna upgrade these tanks just... Oh, actually, I should upgrade you this way at least. Right? How good are you? If I compare the stats, I wanna see the newest one right here. You? No. You're the upgraded ones, yeah. So let's see, recommissioned, good, then I can look at like this. We have 72 hard attack and soft attack, 70 only. Alright, 18 air, 14 speed, 21 air and 16 speed. Armor, 45, 50, this one had 90% reliability, 17, 145. 70, really? Yeah, no, 17 and 145. 17, 145 and 130 in reliability. And this is 90 in reliability. I think I actually wanna stick to these tanks. At least for now. Yeah, I wanna stick to these tanks. Well, until we have the next tank right here. This should at least be quite a bit better than these ones, even if they're gonna be upgraded. Let's see, soft attack 88, yeah, it's gonna be 88. That's gonna be just better than the upgraded one. So, I think I'm gonna ignore you. Yeah, we have better tanks available, but, or a later upgraded version, but we have upgraded these old tanks so much, they're actually better than next level. So we're gonna stick to what we got. That sounds a song. We're gonna stick what we got. We'll give it a shot. Wow. Living on a prayer. We can make a song out of that. About keeping your tanks. We gotta hold on to what we got. It doesn't make a difference. It's if it's one higher level or not. We got our tanks. We could probably modify the text a bit more. Yeah, I have this ridiculous thing. When I suddenly hear something at work or anything, I just... Sometimes just... That could be made into a song. I probably mentioned this before, but I have remade... Well, It's My Life to It's My Reich and a couple of other things. It's My Reich is definitely the best one and most worked one, but that's not something I would ever... The lyrics I would never show to anyone except, well, a couple of people at work have seen it, but it's horrible. It's really horrible. Anyway, let's see. How long before we can clear this war? We have another 32 days. Should we throw off someone else right here? We have Conservative Party, Nationalists. I can't actually go against you since you're even with European Union. Reactionary, that's Russia. Social Democrat, and Reactionary. So I could pull down these two nations too. Oh wait, no. Okay, not you, but... So we have only one more nation in entire Africa we can't touch. No, you too. No, you're Nationalist. Social Democrat, okay, you two nations. Two nations. Okay, yeah, only two nations. So, yeah, I'm fine with me just 100% focusing right here, right now. Right here, right now. And then we're at war with you, so as soon as you fall, we just need to move up our tanks to go in right here. This could maybe be one thing they're nuking us from. Including, of course, goddammit, Gibraltar. So let's double check, how is it looking right now? 32 versus 17, so it's better. We could try to do a very quick invasion right here. You're 6 out of 61. Yeah, I will try to free you. To have you actually good. So let's see, one single unit right here, you're gonna be the preparation right here, and you are destroyed because of nukes. Let's see, do I still have my planes assigned right here? No, I don't. I actually have them, so let's just move you over right actually you can stay right there, but you right here, let's not have you assigned right here. So when you are done with that invasion, or when you're done preparing, I'll try to invade after nuking that place, well, another 1600 times. You improve relationship or... No, Pakistan is improving relationship with you. So we might have some kind of you two creating a faction because you're both Islamic. That wouldn't actually be too bad. Just cleaning up all of this, and that would also give us a board against China if we would like to go against them. You are really powerful, but I don't think you can break my tanks. I just need to gather a large enough force to be able to meet you head on. Because this would be my entire border. I would secure up this front because, well, they can probably naval invade me. Or actually, I would be very much into their face. So if you just focus on grabbing India first, then we could be pretty goddamn safe. Then it would just be a very, very long push to grab their important stuff right here while we constantly nuke them. So that could actually work quite well. I think we want to go and grab China. That would be another 65 more naval factories. Not to mention the 235 and 222 at least civilian and military factories. That could be really good. Alright, anyway, let's go for Iran right now. Wait, before Iran, let's see if you can do it right now. This is gonna be the sign of if this war is gonna go well or not. So, we begin the fight with 5 nukes right here. And then you... Oh, we just obliterated the units that were here. We just completely obliterated whatever units that might have been right here within 5 nukes. So all that time we've been waiting for just, we could have nuked them. Well, they had too many subs last time to actually, well, they blocked our units all the time. But with this additional force right here, increase in destroyer numbers, they couldn't hold on anymore. And finally, this entire area should now be 100% invasion free. If they don't, I don't know, paratrooper make a naval invasion. Since we own both, well, both Suez Strait and we know Gibraltar's. That should be safe now. Right? They don't have any ally right here. No? Cool, cool. Okay, yeah, that should be 100% safe. So this war should also go pretty goddamn well. I'm just gonna take you fighters. And, well, you're done. You're done. Well done. Very nice. You? What should we go for right here now? Everything seems to be very much done. Do we have any industry tech we'd go for? 7 to 10 days. That's a very long time. Let's see. No, no. 500 days, that looks better. When I'm thinking 500 days is good, then something is really bad. And this can increase land knight attack, so yeah, please. Let's sure, we have a 20% bonus right now, so yeah, we have a 20% bonus every night when attacking. So declare this war. Hopefully no one will, well, oh crap, crap, we forgot to stop training them. Mistakes were definitely made. Let's just, you're not attack, actually, you are attacking me, but. Wait, what? Oh. Let's see, do I have any spare tanks anywhere? I don't think so. Well, I guess you could always grab these five. Should we grab a couple of mountaineers? No, then they might be able to naval invade me somewhere. God damn it. let's double check. What should we pick? Should we just deploy a couple of units a bit early? Yeah, let's do it. Let's deploy people who had most training. So you 11 tanks. Under this guy, please. And we need a new leader. So let's just grab one more. Welcome. And you please run down right here. As quickly as you possibly can. You are gonna go down. Actually, I'm gonna control you a tiny bit. Just make sure. No, you are at that front. So I want you to go right in here. Because currently we have protection right here. So these ones should be safe. Just try to get there as soon as possible. While these tanks, both these fronts, just please push in. And let's just, wait, we can't drop a nuke. Oh right, we need to actually assign you to do something. Cool, and let's drop a nuke over there. Let's drop a nuke. Oh, actually, this is gonna be bad. Let's just drop one to destroy, well, the national unity a bit, and not actually their entire infrastructure. Oh crap, it seems like when I nuked you, you got a bunch of improved relationship from different nations. Seems like they don't approve of my nuke tactics. River crossing, very nice. Actually, I want to see if I actually have that 20% bonus, or if it just, it tells me 20% bonus, but it capped at, okay, let's see, this should basically be nighttime. Night plus 20%, so I actually fight better at night. Well, I guess I'm having tanks and, well, they have good night vision. You're both doing this very aggressively, yeah, let's just continue. Okay, Iran is not standing a single chance in hell of surviving that, so I might have overreacted just a tiny bit. You 11 tanks, you are very slowly working yourself down that entire way. Actually, did you both train at least one level? Most of you became at least one level higher. We have a couple of recruits right here, but you should actually get that experience by fighting, hopefully. And you are not surrendering, even if I took that one capital. I would have probably needed to nuke you a bit more, but now supply should be quite horrible. Decent. What? Oh, kill that unit. Please just get in right here. You focus on grabbing that capital. Actually, you can focus on grabbing this from that side. So we have a double approach right here. We can't nuke them actually because that's another air zone. Yeah, Islamic Republic of Iran capitulated. Very good. So you should just continue on this path right now. Get in right here. Both of you guys. So just form up and attack once again. I need one good naval base right here, please. And I can upgrade that one. And I would also like to improve the infrastructure, basically, this entire way. Why I'm doing this much is, well, I'll probably need it once. I just want to secure all of this area once I invade China. And I will probably do it. It's gonna take a while before I'm ready and prepared for this. So I might have overdone this just a tiny bit. Okay, let's just remove some stuff that is not going to be super important. This is going to be more important. I'm going to remove you. I basically just want a very nice road to the sea right here. A very nice road. Basically a very nice autobahn to the sea right here. And let's upgrade you ports too. Yeah, this should basically be it. That should be pretty good. Well, I'm not going to finish all of that, but that's what I want once you are, well, done. And you're just going to push in right here and grab this. So, Afghanistan and Islam Republic of Pakistan. We are definitely going to justify war goal against you. That's going to take 60 days. And then we're also going to go in for Afghanistan. That's going to take 120 days. If we begin right now, it's going to be as quick, well, as we've done one after the other. But that's the only way we can do it. We have 3 dockyards. Very good. Let's see. What are we currently producing, or what are we currently missing the most? I think if it's still destroyers, it wouldn't actually surprise me. This is looking 2023. I think I want, yeah, one more line of missile cruisers right now. So let's do missile cruiser Mark 1. And you get deployed to the Holy Sea. Which is the Vatican fleet. Oh, is that U3 units? Yeah. You'd probably just go back now and just reunite with the big fleet. You have been outside of home sea for such a long time right now. And I can finally welcome you home again. You're home. Okay, let's gather up both of you guys. Just gather up right here. Actually, nothing is preparing right now. Cool. And you're gonna be a search and destroy in... Do we need that area or that area? No. I don't think so. So, yeah, just these two areas. 20 ships and 20 ships. So you're basically doing the same thing as me right now. Actually, search and destroy. Let's go on patrol. So we can have fewer units in the initial engagement, but we can find them more easily. Come on, Canada. Let your entire fleet just fall right now. It would be very nice if I could just clean you out, because you can't escape now. I don't care how you do it, you can't escape right now. That was a carrier and a destroyer. Very nice. We are pushing in slowly but steadily. Actually, not that slowly, it's just... The provinces are pretty big, so it takes a while. How supply? Yeah, horrendous. Actually, really, really horrendous. We're gonna pull back with this entire force. You have lost, actually, you have not lost the right to anything to invade, just they have not enough supply right there. This is also one reason I want to build up this massive network of just ports and the infrastructure all this way. So, please just fall back and the rest of you can just go forward. It seems like you're being very unwilling to do that quickly, so I'm just gonna tell you to do it very quickly. I don't care what happened. And we're playing speed 3 again. What? Have I accidentally started to slow down? That's why everything is going so extremely slowly. Ugh. Ugh. I'm shaking. That's horrible. Please just continue finishing this off. Very nice. Right here. Oh, crap, I forgot about you. I completely forgot about you. Okay, please just go in and grab the capital. Actually, you're not. Just going in and grabbing the capital. You guys, please just surround this entire area. That's what I want. And what you should be able to do. Come on, they're not that good units. Please engage that unit so you can just hold their advance for a while. We should have enough. 11 divisions should be enough for surrounding this territory. Crap, you're expanding quite a bit. Wait, really? A 102 million territory? Holy shit. That's a ton. I need my men back. We are getting 1.8 million men from this single territory. Wow, that's impressive. So please, guys, just move in whenever you can and just bring this back into the fold. Actually, if we could, if it wouldn't be too much of you, since we can just train them out on the field without actually having any penalty. Or, well, of course, there's a small penalty of them not having all their equipment they possibly need. We're actually going to spend equipment now when they're training. That's what I'm trying to say. But we have enough equipment, finally, to do stuff like this. It doesn't really matter. We have enough right now. We just don't have to waste, because manpower is one of the biggest reasons we need to be a tiny bit careful right now. We have these 2 millions, and then we have additional 4 millions if we scrape the barrel. But after that, we have nothing. We need to grab more nations. Right now, it's going quite slowly. So how you... Oh, is it supply issues once again? Yeah, it's actually even worse supply issues. So please just wait here and try to push in right here. Yeah, there shouldn't be any problem. Just go in right here, push right around, and planes. We have some of them right here. That's 200. Okay, I guess we'll just have to assign you right there. And all of you fighters, you should definitely not be fighting over here anymore. That's just taking, well, attrition. You should be split into very few amount. And 189, you can be assigned right here. 65, yeah, you're a bit too many right now, so I'm gonna just take half of you, split you up, and then disband one of those units. Actually, we can split this one up once again and then disband half. Yeah, that looks much better. I want both of you in this territory, fighters. And then we'll see what happens if I nuke this. You are kind of close to surrendering. Not super close, so we're just gonna break your units right here. I know that this is gonna destroy the supply even more, but right now, the tiny bit of supply we currently have, I think it's better for us to have supply than they having supply. Yeah, sure, we're not gonna... Like, we were not gonna get any extra supply, even if everything was not destroyed right here, while they were going to get extra for not being destroyed here. So, just evening out the field with no troops having any supplies, I think that's advantageous for me right now. I want half of you actually go right there, and I want half of, or kind of half of you to go right there. So this should be a pretty good split. And let's just do another additional nuking right here. Come on. How long? Yeah, right. No supply. Takes ages to move. Forgot about that. I always forget about that somehow. We actually don't have enough supply right here, so let's just fix this one. Come on. Like this. Just drag this one out on both sides. How about you, actually? No one really allied with, no one guaranteeing you, no faction. Oh, right, we're gonna remove you too. Let's see, in how many days? Actually, many days. And this can now gonna take 310 days. Oof. Horrible. Finally, you capitulated. Very good. So we're currently at war with, well, a bunch of nations. Wait, shouldn't this war though be over? This war should be over. Or Somalia. Oh, right. You, over here. Have you cleaned you up yet? No, we haven't, actually. So please just go in and grab the capital. That might actually be enough, just grabbing the capital right here. Let's double check your current national unity. Oh, I don't know if that would be enough. Maybe. You might have grabbed something from me. Yeah. Oh, actually, you could be played from that. Alright, cool. Alright, you were part of NATO. You were not. So this is gonna give up. Not that thing. So, take all states. And turn done. And we have expanded once again quite a bit. We have 22 units right here. And you might actually be the extra reinforcements I was talking about right here. That might defend. Alright. You're gonna be like this then. Basically tanks I've just stationed in Africa that's just generally gonna fend the entire Africa from weird naval invasions. Did we lose anything right here? No, it was just a couple of planes. Nothing to complain about. Still no one? Okay, sorry. You're doing better. This supply should just be running through this easier now. And let's see, U18, I want you all surrounding this nation. And oh right, we're just fine against you too. Actually, you are gonna be finished right now. Or in a couple of days. So let's do like this then. You are gonna be right up here. This is not gonna be enough supply for you, 18. But you're gonna fight but not have enough supply. That's all there is to it. And you're gonna be this way. Cool. That works. We should definitely start building at least better supply right here. Just into this like small area. And you're also gonna have top priority right here. Since the more land we grab, the more civilian factories we have, the more stuff we can build at the same time. So there are not all bad things happening to us. Yeah, sure, you're gonna lose some stuff. We're gonna win some stuff. We are fighting more wars, we are taking high attrition, but we are always gaining something from it, so I'm fine with us losing a tiny bit for gaining a lot more in future. One loss for many future victories. I think that's from Avatar. Lost Ember and Lost Airbender. Yeah, I think so. Anyway, you are, having no trouble as usual. Says I, as we are having trouble. A level 5 fort, I guess it's acceptable for you to having a tiny bit of problem right there. Let's just use one of these tanks. It was one unit. And just attack on the side, that will increase the limit. Or the combat width, and that will just make everything good. Bring this down. It will be nice when I finally can remove you and actually unite this as one area. And then we'll have you left. And then we have a full front against China if we want to attack them. I probably want around 60. Like, I want two armies. I want one army stationed right here. And you're gonna push forward right here. And I want one army right here. And gonna push down. Yeah, that would probably be the best win. And then we split up, basically, for Nepal. We're not gonna kill you or have a war goal waiting for you. So this is basically gonna be my split off point. This order is gonna... I might actually do a blitz order and make sure they only basically take India and over India. And Nepal being the splitter. Yeah, that would probably be the best thing ever. God, I'm smart sometimes. Just giving myself some encouragement too. I've been hacking on me for a ton of times for all random mistakes. And this time I haven't done any very big mistakes at least. And I'm actually quite happy with this episode. So, nice. And now let's take you. Thank you. And that's it. You are also away. And we're going to continue while building. Actually, just control shift right now. That will just improve all. And let's build another very nice big port right here. Cool. We are building, well, actually all we want to build, it's basically half of it that has currently factories assigned to it, and the rest of it are basically 200 days plus. That's gonna take a while to build. Anyway, I think I'm gonna end this episode right here, right now. And next episode, probably these nations and then China, or actually probably only this nation and then China. We'll see. We'll see if I feel confident enough. We're definitely gonna pull these units then, but right now, or actually some of the units, we're probably gonna leave 5 of them or something right here in case of China trying to invade us. Otherwise, I'm very happy. We're cleaning up their navy right here. We have taken Gibraltar, finally uniting this territory. We have taken all except 2 nations in Africa that we can take without risk. So I'm really happy. I'm really happy. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Like, comment, subscribe, and all nice stuff. And I will see you guys next time. Bye and bye.